Hey, it's nutritionist and maintainable weight loss coach Trisha Mandis here, and you are watching Take Control Tuesdays, where you learn how to take control of your diet, your weight, and your health. Exciting stuff, I know. Today I'm talking about why you should weigh yourself every day, but how to not go freaking crazy in the process, right? I know this is something that you probably don't like to do. Am I right? If I'm right, say thumbs up, I'm right. Let me know. So the reason that you should weigh yourself every day, one, is that research shows when you weigh yourself every day, you're more likely to achieve a greater amount of weight loss than if you're weighing once a week. But that's not the most important thing when it comes to weight loss, getting on the scale. The food you're putting in your body and how you're working out is way more important. But weighing yourself is also important because you can't go where, you can't know where you're going if you don't know where you are right now. Also, it's going to be a lot harder to know if you're stuck in a plateau or what type of help you need if you don't have the data to actually know where you're at and measure that. So the other reason that it can be good to weigh yourself every day, or at least get on the scale if you don't get on the scale at all right now because you're so terrified of it, is because if you know how much you weigh, you might kick your butt into gear about doing something about it. Am I right? Yes. So how do you not go crazy going on the scale every day? Type a comment in below if that's one thing you hate about going on the scale, is like the emotional angst you feel about it. Well, good news is they've done some meta-analysis and systematic reviews, and studies show that you're more likely to not feel psychological distress from weighing yourself every day versus infrequently. So that's good news. But here's the two things that I do with my clients. One, we have to have proper scale expectations. So if you think the scale is, the number on the scale is going to go down every single day, every single time you step on the scale, you're going to drive yourself freaking nuts because that is just not going to happen. That's like wanting $1 million to just poof, show up on your living room floor because you asked for it, because you sat on the couch and you said, please show up. So you have to understand that the number on the scale is not going to go down every single day, when even when you're eating optimally or when you're doing any type of diet. So it's going to go up and down and up and down, but the overall trend, the average, you want to be going down on a week or a monthly basis. So when I'm working with my clients, I don't give a shit about one daily number. I only care about the average gain or loss in a period of time. Okay, so do not compare one day to the next day because it doesn't mean anything and you're setting yourself up for failure. So proper expectation is the daily number doesn't matter, and the scale, the number on the scale should not be going down every single time that you step on it. On average, my clients lose about 1 to 3 pounds a week. That's a very healthy rate of weight loss. For some people who have just totally killed their metabolism by doing insane amounts of exercise and insane calorie restriction, or if you've been eating keto for a long time, it takes, sometimes those people will have a slower rate of weight loss, maybe about a half a pound a week. But I haven't had anyone who's done every single thing I said not achieve 1 to 3 pounds a week, with a half of a pound a week being the exception. So you also have to know what should happen on the scale. Last thing I'll say is that even when you do understand scale expectations and you do feel some angst or frustration getting on the scale, even though you know that it's going to go up and down while the trend is going out down every day, here's a helpful response you can put in place, and I suggest crafting one of these for yourself. This is from one of my clients, and they read it every single morning, which helps them recalibrate and remember what's really important when they get on the scale. So let's say you hop on the scale, and you are thinking to yourself, oh shit, this isn't working. What the beep? The number is going up again. This is something you can say to yourself every single morning. You want to have it written and you want to read it. It's okay. Today is just today. Sometimes when I do great things for my body, the scale goes up the next day, which isn't bad. Remember, the one single day doesn't matter. The scale is always going to go up and down on a daily basis. The scale is not supposed to go down every day. If I think it is, then I'm setting myself up for failure and I don't deserve to do that. I know what I'm doing is the best thing for me, and Trish is here to help ensure that for me. Now let's kick some ass. And remember, I've already lost 10 pounds in 8 weeks and my joints are already feeling better, etc. So if you've achieved some results from what you're doing now, include that in there. Like, remind yourself, this is working and I'm feeling results and I'm feeling great. So those are my tips for you today on this Take Control Tuesday day. But now I want to hear from you. Answer today's Take Control Now Tuesday question, and that is, do you currently weigh yourself every day? Why or why not? And after watching this video, are you going to start now? Let me know. And if you have any other comments or questions, I'm always happy to hear them. Get educated, get support, and take control. Yes, you can get the healthy body you deserve.